white supremacists have a code. That's my answer. That's why I have tried to have a counter code, meaning a code of what? Thought, speech, and action. See, the lady was correct, I think. If what she was saying was just words alone won't do it. No, words cause people to act. But people have to act on the words that are being said. Now, I have asked black people using words to not celebrate anything, ever, until this problem is solved, called racism. That's a big thing to ask black people to do. I mean, that's over the top. I mean, that brings about instant pain, because black people like to celebrate every 5 minutes, worldwide. We find any excuse to celebrate. And this has worked against us. We should not be a celebratory people. We're not qualified. Get something to celebrate first, then celebrate. You even have some football players, and I've seen some of them do it, and I've heard of others, black football players, who run down the field and throw the ball down before they get to the end zone because they're so intent on celebrating. Black people shouldn't celebrate. They should meditate. And all these days that are set aside for all of this celebration, balloons and all that type of thing, no. Dancing and shaking and going on and whatnot, no. I know it's a tradition, but we should examine traditions. Traditions are supposed to do something, like improve your conditions. Black people's conditions all over the world are absolutely awful, and all the celebrations haven't helped. All it did was just put aspirin, or you might say put a Band-Aid temporarily, just almost like a drug, like cocaine. It just hides the problem. We're not qualified to celebrate. That's right in your face. I underline the word qualified. What qualifies people to celebrate when they have something to celebrate? Well, black people haven't qualified to celebrate. We should put that burden on ourselves by our own evaluation. I'm not talking about waiting on somebody else to evaluate us. We should evaluate our performance against what? Against all the problems that we have. And we should come up after that evaluation and say in one voice, you know what? We're not qualified to celebrate anything. Look at our condition. Look at our neighborhoods. Look at our schools. Look at the long lines, I mean, of unemployed people. And we are celebrating? No, we haven't done the work yet that calls for a celebration, just like any football player will tell you. I mean, recently I heard some football players just this past weekend saying, hey, we got to do better. I mean, this is unacceptable. I mean, they were saying that. Now, we can understand that if we're talking about football, but we don't apply it to anything else. See, we don't have time to be, you know, singing and dancing and whatnot. This is not singing and dancing time. Sing and dance after we get the work done, which means after there's no more racism. That's a tall order. That's a tall order. No singing and dancing until there's no more racism. Suppose every black person on the planet said that in one voice. Just saying that would cause alarm among the white supremacists, if we said it in a minute. Black people don't sing and dance. They don't celebrate anymore. And if they sing, they're singing what they call patriotic songs about justice and et cetera. They're not just singing just to be singing, just to make noise. They're no longer in the noise business. They don't go to concerts and say, everybody make some noise. It's almost like a standard slogan. No. We're not going to make noise. We're going to make music. And music is different from noise. Music causes people to think constructively. And we are going to be in a constructive mode from here on in, starting with right now. And we're not celebrating birthdays, but we already had a birthday. And since then, we've been having slow death days. So let's get on some life days. And the way you do that is to produce a product called justice, and the world is crying out for it. Now, you can have fun doing it. A lot of black people bring it up to me all the time. Well, when do you have fun? you can have fun doing something constructive. Black people have been programmed to think that you have fun by falling down drunk and getting run over by a car. Now, that's fun. We got to get out of that type of thinking. Or lying somewhere in an alley with a needle in our arm in a heap of trash. That's fun. That's what we call fun. Why? Because the white supremacists said, this is some excellent fun for you people. And then they demonstrate some of it themselves to lead us into it. Anything that's non-constructive, that's what they said it should be reserved for black people calling fun. If it's got anything constructive about it, it's not supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be work. It's supposed to be drudgery. It's supposed to make you very unhappy. If it's anything constructive about it, it's supposed to make you unhappy. But something that's pure stupid, pure stupidity, something that's pure foolishness, something that's very wasteful, then that's what is supposed to be designated. Put a big sign on it. This is what you call black fun. Something that is totally non-constructive. Something that's not going to help anybody do anything that makes sense. But that's supposed to be fun for black people. And we have bought into it wholesale, worldwide. And all we have to do is just make up our minds to stop it, and it doesn't take practice. That's another thing. People say it takes a long time to get that way. No, you just make the decision today. And also, another big thing that I repeat over and over again, don't pick up that cell phone or that app or whatever and contact anybody unless you have something constructive to say. So black people will become some of the most silent people in the world because we are not used to constructive conversation. We're so used to what we call jive talking and just talking just to be heard. And they're standing in the middle of the sidewalk getting attention, I mean, by, you know, talking as loud as we can. Want everybody to pay attention to us. And then when we get everybody's attention, we don't have anything constructive to say. And our record proves it. So we can just go silent and do some meditating and do some constructive thinking. The textbook workbook says thought, then speech, then action, and make every last one of them constructive. Black people shouldn't contact not a relative, not a distant friend, not a sorority member or fraternity member, unless you have something constructive to say or do. And since I just mentioned something about fraternities, this nonsense about hazing, I want to say something about it right now, now that I thought about it. How in the world did black people ever adopt anything like that? Anywhere. You're going to beat on somebody in order to be initiated, you say, into an organization? When black people have been beat on ever since there has been black people on the planet. Beat all across the Atlantic slave trade. Beat, beat, beat. Kunta Kinte over and over again. And then you go in a sophisticated university, you're going to say something about, well, we have to initiate you by taking you through some trials of being beat on and humiliated and treated like a dog. No, it should be just the opposite. You should welcome the person into the fraternity by showing them all the constructive things that you do and tell them to embrace all of that. That's if you're doing anything constructive in the first place. Otherwise, you don't have any business having a fraternity if you're not doing anything constructive, if you're just showing out. Enough of that. Black people don't have any license to show off. Nothing. Our record is not good enough to show off anything. Your house, your car, your jewelry, your talents, anything. You use them to try to produce a product called justice. Don't spend 5 minutes showing off anything because most of what you get that you show off, and that's in the book, under one of the four show-offisms, you get it from the white supremacists anyway. So what are you showing off? Your ability to get something from them? The only reason you got it is because they let you have it. Otherwise, you wouldn't have it. So stop showing off the things that the white supremacists allow you to have. Don't spend 5 minutes buying anything just to show off. Look at what I got. Well, where did you get it? Who let you have it? Stop and think. Colored folks,